We have a number of design challenges on OSIRIS-REx that make it a very unique mission to fly. We are navigating in close proximity to an asteroid, and we'll be doing so for 2 years. The asteroid's also only 500 meters across, so it's a microgravity environment, which means that our ability to predict where the spacecraft is long-term is much more difficult. All of these make the uncertainty in our trajectory and our mission plan much more variable than we're used to, and we have to respond much more dynamically to the mission plan changes as this asteroid continues to throw surprises at us. To do that, we need new tools to be more responsive to the mission plan as it evolves. The digital twin allows us to more rapidly and robustly evaluate a mission plan before we have to fly it. We build our mission commanding a week at a time, and we test it in our system level test beds, but that's a lot of data for us to sift through. They say a picture is worth 1,000 words. Well, the digital twin lets us turn the nearly 30,000 telemetry channels from OSIRIS-REx into a visualization and a series of pictures that's much easier for us to interpret and evaluate and assess with our engineering judgment. OSIRIS-REx is a groundbreaking mission that is going to bring back a sample that's going to help explain some of the origins of our solar system. But we're also demonstrating new technologies in rendezvous and proximity operations that will help further the field of asteroid exploration. All of this is new and challenging, and the digital twin is allowing our team to meet those challenges for the first time.